All right, so you have decided to run your very own Bitcoin Lightning Network node, and now you want to know what the best hardware is to buy. Well, stay tuned, because in this video, I am going to share with you the mistakes that I made, why I ended up repurchasing things two or even three times, and what hardware you should buy to run your very own node at home. When you first get started running your node, you are likely to just go with whatever is recommended, especially in the case of things like Umbrel or Citadel. But I want to actually encourage you to do a little bit more research before you simply buy everything on their shopping list. And that's because when I set up my very own node, I made a few mistakes that ended up costing me tens or even hundreds of dollars because I bought exactly what they told me and then decided that it didn't suit me. Now, before we go any further, I want to point out that this is specifically for running a node on your very own hardware in your house. Of course, you can, if you want, run a node in the cloud through Voltage. I've talked about that in previous videos. That's not what this video is about. Instead, this video is about figuring out what the absolute best hardware is for running your node at home. Now, in order to make this easier for me to explain to you and easier for you all to pick up these parts and support the channel using affiliate links, I've created a kit.co page, which I will link in the description below to show you all the different things. And I'm going to go through them kind of one by one and explain to you exactly what you're going to need. Now, first and foremost, I want to say most people are running a node on a Raspberry Pi 4. You cannot run Umbrel or Citadel on a Raspberry Pi 3B. But that doesn't mean that you can't use more powerful hardware instead of the Raspberry Pi. So there are some options out there. I know Darth Node, someone who I look up to, really swears by the idea of running it on a mini PC. The thing about those mini PCs is that most of them come with a 500 gigabyte drive, and you need a minimum of 1 terabyte. And if you want to future-proof your node or store other things on it like media, you're probably going to want to get a 2 terabyte SSD, which I'm going to add to these later. SSD is the least important part. So I've gone ahead and added a mini PC option that you can check out if you want to run a more powerful node. But I have to say, honestly, two things. One, any old computer that you have kicking around the house will work as long as you have a 1 terabyte SSD, not a standard hard drive. It needs to be an SSD or it is going to be way too slow for you to be able to actually validate all the blocks. And you need to be able to run Linux on it. So I know most old computers, if it's a Mac, if it's a Windows machine, you will be able to install Linux. And while it's going to be a little bit trickier to install on an old PC or a mini PC like this, you definitely can do it. But the other thing is, I'm not really convinced that for just routing or processing transactions on the Lightning Network, you actually need more processing power than a simple Raspberry Pi. I know people who are running really, really powerful nodes on a Raspberry Pi. And if you're running an enterprise-grade node, you probably should run it in the cloud, as I talked about in my video on how to accept Bitcoin payments. So let's leave the mini PC option and assume that you are going to instead run, as most people do, on a Raspberry Pi, especially because this mini PC, the cheapest one I could find with a 1 terabyte SSD, was about $800 on Amazon. Now, of course, if you're running on an old machine, an old laptop that you have, then that's going to be free for you, and you should just do that. Why spend money on a Raspberry Pi and another hard disk and a case and all those other things if you already own an old PC? So stop right here if you have an old laptop that you're not planning on selling, which has more than a 1 terabyte solid state drive. All right, with all those caveats out of the way, let's talk about Raspberry Pi. Now, I already mentioned that you do have to run on a Raspberry Pi 4, but I didn't mention how much memory you need. Now, this is really going to depend on how many apps you want to run on your node, how much speed you want them to run at. I've seen people show that on Umbrel or Citadel, you can run lots of apps and it still doesn't consume more than 4 gigabytes of RAM. Personally, I decided to spend another 20 or 30 bucks and just get the 8 gigabyte, so you have as much as you need in case in the future you want to host more things. Personally, I'm hosting BTC Pay over Tor, through my node. People are actually using my node to check out on my website for my coaching, consulting, and Bitcoin statuettes. You don't want to have to unplug your node and rip out the core of it. Just get the 8 gigabyte. It's totally worth it. The next thing, as I mentioned, that you need is going to be the solid state drive. Most people just get the cheapest 1 terabyte drive out there, and this Crucial Max one works well. I'll also share some on AliExpress, but personally, I ended up changing out and getting another hard disk for the 2 terabyte SSD because, as I said, I'm hosting some things on my node, and while I'm not hosting pictures and files and all kinds of other crap on my node, I am hosting different things that I don't really want to talk about, so we're not going to talk about it. But in addition to that, the blockchain is always growing, and in the next couple of years, we all will need to upgrade our nodes to a 2 terabyte SSD. So if you want to save money and not make the mistake that I and everyone else made, just upgrade to the 2 terabyte one now. It's going to be a little bit more expensive, but if you buy it on something like AliExpress, I will put links in the description and I will share the kit.co link. Then you end up saving money because you're not going to have to buy a 1 terabyte and then another 2 terabyte disk later. Let's touch really, really quickly on power supplies. Yes, you need the authentic Raspberry Pi USB-C power supply. Do not go messing around with other power supplies. They will not work well. You will have problems. Your node will give you all kinds of issues. Don't do it. Just buy the authentic Raspberry Pi power supply. Stay away from AliExpress on this one. Trust me, it's not worth messing around, and you will waste money, as so many people did, buying a cheaper power supply because you're gonna end up buying the original one anyway. As far as the SD card goes, honestly, you only need 16 gigs. You're not storing anything on there except for the operating system, and the cheapest one you can find is totally fine. I've linked some in the kit.co. Don't overthink it. Now, the next thing you need to make a decision on is the format of your node. And I know a lot of people end up just plugging in one of these basic Orico 2.5 external drives, and that's okay, but it's really ugly, and you're going to end up needing one of these cables, and then you're going to need a case, and your node's going to be ugly because the hard disk is going to be separated from the main brain of the Raspberry Pi, and I didn't want to do that. And to be honest, this is why CryptoCloaks exists. CryptoCloaks makes these awesome full cases that encapsulate everything all in one. So for example, you have the Triton or the Palace, and that puts everything all into one case. And then all you need is a special kind of adapter from the USB of your Raspberry Pi into the SATA. This, one of these things. Then you need one of those and you can put it in the CryptoCloaks. But truthfully, I decided not to go with the CryptoCloaks shell because I am not an advocate of displaying your node prominently. I think that's asking for people to steal it. And as I talked about in my Bitcoin security video, physical access to your node could mean that someone is able to steal your funds if they steal your node. So I ended up not going with one of these. And instead, I chose from two different options that are used for the Raspberry Pi, not specifically for nodes, but for Raspberry Pis and personal media servers. Now, again, you can go with one of these iUniker cases or whatever other case you find on AliExpress or Amazon, but if you want everything to be in one unit, there's really only two very good options that I found outside of CryptoCloaks. The first one is the Geekworm Raspberry Pi case. It's just this nice, basic black box with vent holes, completely unassuming. And what's cool about that is they also offer an upgraded SSD adapter, which has a built-in fan on it. You can see it right here. And what this does is it adds cooling adaptively based on the temperature of the Raspberry Pi. You just have to install a little bit of software. And it also plugs into the SSD without needing that cable adapter. So it's this whole board that attaches onto the Raspberry Pi and makes everything in one unit, nice and neat and clean. And if you listen closely, you can actually hear the fan of my Raspberry Pi working away adaptively to the temperature. Now, this case is cool because you can use it with the original power supply, or it also adds the ability to add another power supply, which is not USB-C, Again, I didn't do that. I didn't mess around with it. I just went with a USB-C power supply. And it was easy. It works. You get a nice little power reset button on there. And there are no cables except for the power cable and, of course, the Ethernet cable, which you are going to need. The second option, if you want everything to be all-in-one, is the Argon One. It's this really beautiful case. Now, the Argon One also has built-in cooling, so really, really efficient cooling, according to them. And it's kind of a all-in-one system where you've got everything that you have with the Geekworm all-in-one kind of baked-in system. Now, I haven't tried this, so I don't know how the cooling works or if it's adaptive. But I do know that it has the GPIO pins accessible on the top of the case, meaning you can plug other things into your Raspberry Pi if you so wanted to. I don't think you'd want to. I don't know what you would plug into your Raspberry Pi if it's running a node. And you also don't need the two full-sized HDMIs because your node is not going to have HDMI output. You're going to access it from a browser. So don't worry about any of that. But I will say the Argon One used to be $100+. And now it's only $47. So it's actually a really, really affordable option for those of you who want this sleek look, really good cooling, and all in one with no hard disk sitting on the outside. The only thing about the Argon One that you do have to be careful of is if you go that route, you actually need a totally different SSD. You're going to need one of these, the M.2 SSD, which is similar to the type of SSD that you would use on a laptop or small computer. And those can be much more expensive than a standard SSD. Here you can see this one is $89 for a 1 terabyte SSD. I haven't checked these prices in so long, but I would venture a guess that it's going to be actually much, much cheaper if you use the standard SATA SSD. We can see here if I'm right. Well, it's actually not that much cheaper. So ultimately, what this is going to come down to is what look do you like? Do you like the Crucial or do you like the Argon? And also, it's worth noting that with the Argon, that case should actually allow you to directly connect to the hard disk. So you're not going to need this additional adapter that I have from Geekworm. So whereas in the past, when I did this, actually the best route was to piece it all together from Geekworm, it actually looks like in the time since I did my own node, the Argon One is a really, really affordable option and has everything that you need to connect that M2 hard disk and connect to the fan. It also looks like they have an expansion board, which is interesting. I'm really not sure what that's for or what you would do with it, especially when running a node. I know that Geekworm also has a UPC or a power bank thing, but it doesn't work with the SSD adapter. If you're thinking about adding a battery to your node, that doesn't work. I don't think with either of these. I'd have to do a little bit more research. But frankly, if your whole power goes out, probably your internet's gonna go out anyway, so that doesn't matter. To summarize this nice, big, long rant, you have a lot of different options, but make sure that you think about the final format that you want to go with when buying your node. If you want just this nice, clean box and one unit like that, go with a Geekworm and you can add on the kind of hat that allows it to have a fan and attach to the SSD. If you want this really sleek look, go with the Argon One and don't worry about the cable. Just know that you're going to need to get an M2 SSD. And if you want to save money and go the cheapest route, get any old Raspberry Pi case with a fan, get this simple Orico 2.5 external drive enclosure, and you'll be all set. Just know that you are going to end up spending more money if you decide to put everything together in one box. And I don't know about you, I thought it was really ugly to have this separate box and a wire running, so that's just me. I really hope this video has been helpful. If you want to support the channel, please take a moment to use the affiliate links below and check out our website where we offer one-on-one node coaching. Yes, I will help you one-on-one set up your node, increase your routing, open channels, connect to your wallet, whatever you need at affordable rates. You can check that out at bitcoinftm.com. Make sure you're subscribed because we have a lot more great content like this coming. Take care.